Welcome back. Let's start with football, and to be accurate, with African football. And to be more accurate, with the Confederations Cup final, which took place yesterday between Pyramids of Egypt and Nahda Berkane of Casablanca. It ended 1-0 for the Moroccans, and they clinched the title. But this 1-0 match, how was it? What were the most important mistakes or defects with Pyramids' tactics and with Pyramids' squad and with the first lineup of the Egyptian team? All this and more with our dear guest via phone, Mr. Mohammed Rashad, our sports analyst. Hello, sir.
How are you? How are you?
Have a very good morning first, and I was speaking about this Chichich. I don't know how to pronounce his name well, but the lineup which started yesterday with Pyramids was really astonishing, as if he was that afraid of Nahda Berkane, taking into consideration that he is there in Morocco, and with this closed way of dealing with the whole story, he was defeated 1-0, and we were not able to clinch the title, despite the fact that if we look and in detail to each player in Pyramids, you would find a team in itself. First, I'd like to have your evaluation of this lineup of Chichich before going into the details.
You know, Pyramid, it was founded 3 years ago.
Yeah.
And he went all the way to the final at Total Cup. She has taken a happy ending. Well, but what happened in Morocco, and what this is big questions, you know. If you have a referee, it's supposed to be the final, it's supposed to be, you know, you seek to be good. Because what happened yesterday, you know, it make us fear about what we're going to do in the Malik, we're going to play. If we're not going to play here in Egypt, it's not a problem, but problem the referee. And in the final, this is also we're going to play in Egypt between Ad, inshallah, and the Malik. But what happened to the Pyramids, you know, they done what they supposed to do. They reached the final, and they have a big ring to go. And what happened yesterday, because you have a supposed referee, it make me happy with Premier Augustus, with Sikazori, who was the referee of the match of Ahli, and with that, he have a problem because much of Premier Augustus and not his Tunisian team is problems. He made it think not good, and even he was suspended for 6 months. And you make him referee again, this is a big problem. This is, you know, it's not fair what we're going to do. And what is in sport is supposed to have fair and supposed to have sportsmanship and this thing. Because this is an image of what has to be done after what happened, the coronavirus and what happened. I think it's not fair. You know, now that Berkane, they play. Also, Pyramids play. But what happened, this is, I know. You know, what did Berkane start the match with Zahir Arouri for goalkeeping? In defense, Ahmed Aziz, Issoufou Diouf, Maïl Mokaddem, Omar Nimsawi, and in the defense, this is Nagy Al-Arabi, Zaid Kraouch, Zakaria Al-Khadrafi, Bakr Al-Hilali, and Hamza Al-Hashi. And for the attack, Mohsen Yagur. And for the Pyramids, El Mahdi Suleiman, Ifen, Ahmed Tawfiq, Dalla Bakri, Ali Gab, Ahmed Ayman Mansour, Ahmed Hamdi, Nabil Donga, Omar Gabir, Ahmed Farouk, and Abdullah Said. Mm-hmm. And for attacking, Arik Shaouri. You know, I'm here coach, the Pyramid coach, the Croatian coach, is a very good coach. He do what he's supposed to do in him. In tactic and alteration in some, and you know Pyramids where they are fighting for that in the second place in Egypt. Yeah, but they are. If you
I beg your pardon, sir. Then you still consider the Croatian Chichich, the coach of Pyramids, after being defeated yesterday And after being till the last moment competing with Al Zamalek on the second spot of the Egyptian Premier League, and after losing in Egypt Cup just recently, still he is considered a good coach?
No. A good coach, it means La Presse, who he is now, and Pyramids, and his deputy, and he was good. He was supposed to be a tactical coach, a good coach. If you lose and lose, every coach will going to lose. Every coach will going to lose many competitions. But it's not City, you are not good, you have something, you have the experience. Many, if they win, what are you going to do to them? It will be the best coach. But what happened in the referee is not meaning. Yes, he play a match, he do what he done, and at the end, this is the football, you know. Zidane in the Clasico, if he lose, he's going to be out. It's not mean he's not a good coach. It's not what happened to him. This is nothing. You play what you're going to do, and then the score is nothing. You can do it. Something.
Sir, also, I cannot skip speaking about Al Yomniyont when it comes to the match which took place yesterday. First, in the first place, why Al Yomniyont, this Cameroonian referee, after what happened between Al Zamalek and Al Raja under him, and the criticism he had and the provocations he made, and even the plea by Al Raja against his performance, calling his performance there catastrophic. Why he was chosen by the CAF to run this crucial encounter? This is number one. Number two, what about his decisions yesterday, whether him or the VAR referee?
You know, I said before, in the CAF, you have a big problem in the referee. Shekazuri, he may have played much early. He played four times again a Moroccan team. Three times in the main field. And then the coach, who is the Malik, who have a good problem, big problem. Yesterday, the Moroccan TV will have a documentary. And this documentary was very, very, I don't know, it's going to have a problem after this. Because after this documentary and what the referee did yesterday, it means they want to do something not good. Because the Moroccan team have a big, they said the Federation CAF have a big problem, and they helping the Egyptian team, the Malek, and they said, you know, it belongs to 1 month ago, Captain Fogafar, this is a legend in the Malek, and he was speaking about something. I don't know why he speaking about this. Is what the cause, but it's not supposed to do it. And in the Malek TV. So this problem, they take this, what he said, and many matches, and even they said what happened. This is a big problem. You know, we have a problem in the CAF team. This is a big problem. And he's so much in Ahli when we make a problem in it was not a penalty. It was not a penalty. And alhamdulillah, Ahli scored in the 3 minutes. You know, it's a time. This penalty can lose the match. You know? This is a big problem. I hope the federal the CAF because this big problem. This is big. And you remember last year there was a final match against Wydad Ayarogo and Liverpool Tunisian. And what happened was a scandal too. But it was in the final. You know, this is a big problem. And I don't know what to say, but it's a scandal. It's a shame what happened. The sport, they are it's not good. Not good.
Anyhow, I think this refereeing issue is going to remain that controversial in Africa, and in my humble opinion, when it comes to the African referees, Victor Gomez of South Africa and Radwan Jayed in specific of Morocco, in addition to Mustafa Ghorbal of Tunisia, those are the closest to us, are on top of the list right now. But since you mentioned Al Ahli, sir, since you mentioned the matches of the Champions League, the final is going to be, inshallah, played here in Egypt on the 6th of November between Al Ahli and the one to qualify between Al Zamalek and Al Raja. Pitso Mosimane, this South African coach, with what he has done with Al Ahli, at least till the moment, do you think that he opened the gate in front of African coaches to be responsible for big teams like بيتسو ماسماني did now with الأهلي, now الزمالك, Pyramids, even الإسماعيلي and other big or heavyweight teams should search for an African coach or a coach at least with experience in the African footballs, like Hervé Renard, for example?
You know, Mr. Mani is a good coach. He was one of the best coaches in South Africa. And he's a coach, not South Africa, in the African country. He was very good. He was prepared. He has experience. And he has the personality to be in this. He's lucky because when you have training at club, big club like Ahli, player and Mr. Khatoul Khatib, second in the club, they're helping you to go to far. Choosing Mosimani is an adventure. I think in Egypt here, the Makassar bring Emmanuel Amunike and he's not succeed. You cannot bring any African coach. You're supposed to have someone like him. And he's helping and he's good, he's doing very well, and he has a personality, and when he shoots his stuff, when he treats his player, when he has that, when he goes to Morocco to the match, he said something very good, and it is it. This, what he said, he said, no, why you can go there to have draw, why you can dream or win. This feeling come to the player, and now he said we not take the because we win there and win here and we have. He said no, it's not finished. They have a final match important. This is he's stable. He has this is very good, you know.
Yeah.
And we hope you got something in the different. And
yes,
the Ahli, Zamzamalek have a good coach here. Coach, how he played, how he. Match.
Anyhow, you know, the competition is now more among the coaches even rather than the players. Mr. Mohammed Rashad, our sports analyst, thank you very much for your input, sir, and have a very good day. Right, after the short break, we are going to be back with more, so stay tuned.